In this tutorial, I will give an overview of how you can create a control system using an Arduino device. So here you see the contents of this tutorial. First, a short introduction to the tutorial, a short overview of Arduino and the Arduino platform, an overview of a control system in general, a PI controller, and a mathematical model for the PI controller we can implement in this system. I will provide a process and then a mathematical model of this given process, which we will use in this control system. So we will use the PI controller in order to control this process and the mathematical model of this process. Finally, I will also implement a low pass filter. When you only are using the mathematical model, you typically don't need a low pass filter, but when you are applying the real process, we need typically a low pass filter in order to remove noise from the system. And then finally, I will show the final implementation of this control system, where I control this given process, or actually the mathematical model of the process, using the PI controller we are going to create and this low pass filter. Will also be used in order to remove noise from the system. First, short introduction. So, we will create a basic control system using Arduino. In this tutorial, we will use the Arduino Uno device, which is the most common Arduino device. But of course, other Arduino devices may also be used. We will implement a simple PI controller. We will implement a mathematical model, which we will simulate and control using the PI controller. So we will implement the PI controller from scratch using Arduino software. And finally, we will also implement a low pass filter from scratch using Arduino software, which we will implement in the control system. So here you see an overview of a basic control system in general. So this is the control system we are going to create using the Arduino platform. So we are having a process. In this case, we'll use a mathematical model of the process in form of a differential equation. And then we will implement and use a PI controller that we will use to control this process at a given set point. So we start with a short overview of the Arduino platform. So Arduino is an open source electronic platform based on easy to use hardware and software. It's intended for anyone that making interactive projects, from kids to grown-ups. And you can connect different types of sensors, like temperature sensors, etc. And these Arduino devices has pins that you connect, like sensors, etc. And you also have digital output that you can use to control different devices. It's typically used a lot in Internet of Things projects. You find more information about Arduino on their homepage. So Arduino is a small microcontroller. Here you see this Arduino Uno device in full size, so it's not very large. It's a tiny device that you can use for many purposes. Like in this case, we are going to create a basic control system. So it has analog input pins and so-called pulse width modulation pins, and it has digital input and output pins, which you see here on top and in the bottom. And you have a USB connector and an external power supply. The price is about $20 for this Arduino Uno, but you can also get different Arduino starter kits that you can use for your projects. So lots of different Arduino boards do exist. These different Arduino boards has different features, and the different boards are tailor-made for different applications. You find an overview of the different boards at this location, but the most common one and the device that we are going to use in this tutorial is this Arduino Uno. So the first thing you need to do is to connect your Arduino board to your computer using a USB cable. And then when the hardware is set up, you need to download the Arduino software. You can download it for free from the Arduino webpage. And here you see an overview of the Arduino software. And typically all Arduino programs needs to have this basic structure on top. You can have some initialization, define global variables, etc. And then you have this setup function where you put in some initialized code for different things depending on the program you are going to create. And then you have this main loop where you create your main application. So let's start with our control system that we are going to create using the Arduino software. So we are going to create a mathematical model of a given process which we need to implement in Arduino software, and then we are going to create and implement a PI controller that we are going to use to control this mathematical model of this given process. So both the process in form of a mathematical model should be implemented, and this PI controller should be implemented in Arduino software. And here you see an overview of the code structure. So we have these two functions, the setup. Here we should put some initialization, and then in the main loop we need to create different functions. So we are going to create one functions for the function for the PI controller and one for the process model. And typically inside the loop we also need to have a delay, typically 1 second or something. So let's start creating the PI controller. So now we are going to focus on creating this PI controller which we are going to use to control this process or this mathematical model. So here you see the mathematical formula for the PID controller. This is the general PID controller, but in our tutorial we are going only to create a PI controller. So this means we have removed this D from the controller. So here is the general PID controller. This is the P part, the proportional part. This is the integral part, and this is the derivative part. Typically in many control systems you don't need this derivative part. So we only, in most cases, only need this proportional part and the integral part. So we end up with this basic PI controller, which have the proportional part and the integral part. And for this PI controller, we have two tuning parameters, which is KP, which is the proportional gain you find here, and the integral time TI, which you find here. And then E is the error between the reference value. So R is the reference value or the set point. This is the value we want the process to stay on. Typically it could be a temperature value if you have a process that are controlling a temperature value. So then we could set, for instance, R equal to 25 degrees Celsius or something. And then Y is the measured value, which you see here. So the output of the process is the measured value. So we want this measured value to be on the set point we set here on the PI controller. And then based on the error between the measured value and the reference value, the control calculates a proper control signal that it applies to the process or the mathematical model in this case. So actually this is the formula that we need to implement in the Arduino software, but we cannot implement this equation directly. We need to find a discrete version of this PI controller. So here you see how we can find this discrete PI controller. We start with this so-called continuous time PI controller, which is this equation. Then we can derive both sides in order to remove this integral. So we end up with this formula. And then we have this U derivative and E derivative here. We can apply a discretization method like Euler. So we will use Euler backward discretization method and apply it on this formula. And then we end up with this formula. And finally, we end up with this basic equation, which is a discrete version of this continuous PI controller, which we are going to implement in the Arduino software. So here you see a basic implementation of this PI controller. So we are just implementing this discrete version of the PI controller, this basic formula, and we apply it or implement it in a function. So we call the function PI controller or something, and then inside the PI controller we implement this equation, where E is the error between the reference value and the process output. So in this case we are going to control a process called air heater, which is a temperature process. So we are going to control the temperature within this process. But first we implement the PI controller, and then we will implement the mathematical model for this process afterwards. So here is the basic formula for the PI controller. And typically this control signal should be between 0 and 5 voltage, since this is the basic output of different microcontrollers. And also the variables needed here can be implemented either here locally in this function, but for simplicity I have implemented all the variables on top and used them as global variables. So here I have our variable for the reference value or the set point. Here I have KP and TI, which is the tuning parameters for the PI controller. And the starting point for the control signal is just set to 0, and then a new control signal will be calculated based on this formula. So next, let's implement the process or the mathematical model that represents this process. So now we are going to focus on this part, the process of the control system. So now we have found a basic PI controller that we can use. So here is the PI controller we are going to use. So this is this one. And now we are going to create a mathematical model of the process. So here you see an overview of the mathematical, the process we are going to use in this tutorial. It's called an air heater system. Basically, it's a small scale industrial process, where you control the heater, which you have here, and then we measure the output temperature here. So this is what we are going to control using this PI controller. So we are going to control this process, which is given here, and we are going to control the output temperature of this unit. So here you see the actual process, the air heater process we have at our university. It's just an example we are going to use in this when we are creating this basic control system. Of course, you can use any kind of process. This is just an example used in this tutorial. So, this is a sketch of the system. This is the real system. But in this tutorial, we are not going to use the real system. We are only going to control a mathematical model of this system. So here in the bottom, you see the mathematical model or differential equation of this system. And the same as for the PI controller, we cannot implement this equation directly in Arduino. We need to create a discrete version of this this system. And also here, as I did for the PI controller, we also here for this air heater system. This is the differential equation for the air heater system. Also here we can apply and find a discrete version of this system using this Euler forward method. So this is the equation for the Euler approximation. So we replace this derivative with this approximation, and then we will find a discrete version on this form. So x of k plus 1 equals to x of k plus etc. So then we end up with this equation. So we replace this one with this approximation, as you see here, and here is the equation on the right side. We replace t, which is the continuous time, with this k, which is a discrete time interval. So then we end up with the following equation like this. A problem with this equation, it has a time delay, theta d in this case. The time delay is caused by that this air is flowing through this tube. So then we have a delay from we apply a control signal here on this heater until we see the changes here in the outflow. So then this long tube causes a time delay in this system. But to make it simple, we can start by setting this time delay just equal to zero. So this, we just remove this part from the equation in order to make it more simple to implement this discrete equation of this system. And then later, we can also implement the time delay, but we start with a simple equation without the time delay, and then we end up with the following equation, which is just a discrete version of this differential equation, which we can easily implement in the Arduino software. So here, this is the discrete version of the air heater system without the time delay, or set the time delay equal to zero. And then we can also use, in this simulation, use the following model parameters: T theta 22 seconds, KH 3.5, and the environmental temperature 21.5 degrees Celsius or something. So this is just an example. Of course, you can use other values. And then you also set the sampling time, TS equals to 0.1 second. And then we end up with the following implementation of this mathematical model. So we have in Arduino software implemented a separate function called air heater model, and then we implement this equation for the air heater system like this. And also here we need different variables. So just for simplicity, I have put all the variables on top of my program as so-called global variables. So now we have implemented the process in form of a mathematical model of this so-called air heater system, which is just an example process used at the university. And also we have implemented a PI controller from scratch. And finally, we also want to implement a low pass filter in order to remove noise from the process. But of course, we are only simulating this system, so actually don't need a low pass filter. But in this simulation of the control system, we will, when we are getting this simulated system up and running, then we will take the next step and implement the PI controller on this real air heater system, which you find here. And when we read data from a real system, we typically need to use a low pass filter in order to remove noise from the measured value. So this is the Arduino control system we will end up with. We will have a controller implemented from scratch, a PI controller, and we will have a mathematical model of the process. And then we will finally implement this low pass filter as well. So this is the final control system in this tutorial. So why do we need a low pass filter in measurement systems and control system? We typically need to deal with noise, and noise is something that we typically don't want to have in a control system. So low pass filter are created and used to remove noise from the measured signal. So then we have the measured signal here, and then this signal goes through the filter, and then we will have this measured value without noise that are going into the controller. So noise is typically a high frequency signal, and that's why we need to use a low pass filter in order to remove the high frequency signals from the measurement. So here you see a formula for a general low pass filter, and also here. And this system is on a transfer function form, so we can transform it to a differential equation. Then we get it on this form. And also here we can use this Euler approximation method in order to find a discrete version of the low-pass filter. So then we apply this Euler approximation on this formula, and then we end up with the following equation for the discrete low-pass filter. So then we can implement this equation as a separate function in our Arduino software, as you see here. So now we have created a new function in Arduino called low-pass filter, and inside this function we have implemented the mathematical formula for the low-pass filter. And also in this case we need some variables, and I also in this example just put all the variables as global variables on top in order to make it more simpler. So now we have implemented a PI controller, we have implemented a mathematical model of the process, and we have implemented the low-pass filter. So then we will end up with this basic structure of the Arduino program. So on top here we have all these variables we have created for the different low-pass filter, for the PI controller, and for the mathematical model. And then we need to set up some stuff here in the setup part, and then our main program will be have this basic structure. We call the function for the PI controller, we call the function for the mathematical model, and then we call the low pass filter. We wait for a given time, and then this goes into an eternally loop until we plug out the power of the Arduino device. So now I have opened the Arduino software, and here you see the final implementation of this Arduino control system. So let's start with the main loop, which you see here. So here you find the function for the PI controller, which you find here. So this is the implementation of the PI controller. Here you have the function for the air heater model, which you find here. So this is the function for the that implements this mathematical model of the air heater, the discrete version. And then we have this low-pass filter here, which you find here. So this is the function for the low-pass filter that implements this mathematical model of the low-pass filter. And then also in this case I'm using the serial plotter, which you find here under tools. So we have the serial monitor, which you can use to log values from different variables, but you also have a serial plotter that you can use in order to plot plot the value. In this case we are going to plot the temperature value of this air heater process here in the serial plotter. So also I have created a function for the serial plotter, which you find here. We just use this serial dot print line, and then it just prints this temperature value, which is the output of the air heater process, to the serial plotter. And then finally we have this delay, and also here on top you find all my variables which I have created as global variables in this case, just to make it simple. So I have some variables for the simulation system. We have the sampling time set to 0.1 second in this case. Here I have all the variables for the air heater model, and here I have the variables for the controller. We have the reference value set to 24 degrees Celsius in this case. We have KP, TI, etc. And here I have all the variables for the low pass filter. And also in order to use this serial plotter, I just need to start the serial communication like this. And this is done in the setup function. So now we have actually created a basic control system from scratch. We have created a PI controller, a model of the process, this so-called air heater system we are using in this tutorial. We have created a low-pass filter, and also we are using the serial plotter in order to plot the output of the process. So now let's just download or upload this code to the Arduino device. So I just click on this button, and then the code here will be uploaded to the device. And when this code is uploaded, this program will start to execute. So done uploading, then you're gonna go to tools here and the serial plotter, and then you will get a plot of the system. This is the initial value for the process, and you have set this reference value or the set point to be 24 degrees Celsius. So now we can hope that this PI controller are able to control and put the output of this process to the given set point. And as you see here, it has a little overshoot here, and then it goes and end up on the reference value, which is 24 degrees Celsius. So then this shows that we have been able to create a basic control system where we have created a PI controller, a mathematical model of the process, a low pass filter from scratch. And as you see, we are actually able to control this mathematical model and put it on the set point like this. So we ended up with the following Arduino control system. We was implementing a mathematical model of a given process. We was implementing a PI controller from scratch. That the purpose with this controller is to control this mathematical model or the process itself. So to make sure that the output stays on a given set point or a reference value. And then also, when we later are going to use the real process instead of the mathematical model, we should also have a filter, a low pass filter, that are used to remove noise from the measured value, which are used as part of the controller. And we ended up with this Arduino software and this following result, where we in this example just set the reference value or the set point to 24 degrees Celsius. And then as you see from this plot, we was actually able to control this mathematical model of the process on this given set point. So summary, we have made a simple control system from scratch using Arduino. And the code examples shown in this tutorial are very simplified, and lots of improvements can be made. For instance, we can reduce the use of local variables, etc. We should also structure the code into classes and typically make an Arduino library for this general PI and the low pass filter we have created. And then we can use this library in other applications as well. We can add features for storing the data to either an SD card, to a cloud service, or a database, etc. And also one thing with the Arduino system, it has no graphical user interface. So the user cannot set set point like KP, TI, etc. during execution. But here we can use a cloud service or something, create a web application in order to set these parameters remotely. And also the final step is to use Arduino to control the real system instead of this mathematical model. But that's for a later tutorial. So this here you can see how you can implement this system on the real system. So instead of the mathematical model, we use the real process. And we are using the Arduino as the control device, where we have implemented a PI controller in the Arduino software and a low pass filter in the Arduino software. And then we read the process output into the Arduino using the analog input pin here. Since Arduino Uno has 6 analog input pins, we can use one of those. And the output of the PI controller, this U, the control signal, should be put back to the process and control the process. But one drawback with this Arduino Uno, it has no analog output. It has only analog input, but no real analog outputs. So typically we need to use a digital to analog converter chip in order to be able to output an analog signal and control the real process. But that's for another tutorial. So that's all we was able to do in this tutorial. So good luck with your Arduino applications and your control applications. So thank you and goodbye.